Short bowel syndrome is a condition in which patients either have lost a large amount of their intestine, or they were born with an insufficient amount of intestine, or their intestine just simply doesn't work well enough. And the end result is they can't absorb enough nutrients from eating or from feeding through a G-tube or a J-tube to the point that they need supplemental nutrition through an IV line. There are a variety of causes. The causes are different in children and adults. In kids and babies in particular, the number one cause is necrotizing enterocolitis, which is a severe infection that's most common in premature infants. And this infection can be devastating. The intestine can get diseased and then frankly get necrotic and die, and then the surgeon has no choice but to take out the diseased segment to save the baby's life. But then the children are left with short bowel syndrome. Other kids are born with an insufficient amount of intestine. That's known as intestinal atresia. Still other kids may have a normal amount of intestine at birth, and then and it works well for a month or two or even a few years, and then one day it just twists. And that's because it wasn't configured properly when they were inside their mom in the womb. And that condition is intestinal malrotation with a midgut volvulus. And the problem with the twist is that they can lose most, if not all, of their small intestine and be left with short gut syndrome. Other kids will have enough length of intestine, but it won't work. And one disease is Hirschsprung's disease, where the intestine is not innervated properly. That can affect a small portion of the intestine normally, but it can also infect a large portion, if not all, of the intestine. And those kids will need that intestine resected, and then they're left with short bowel syndrome. Another cause that we see in babies is gastroschisis, which is a hole in the anterior abdominal wall next to the umbilical cord. And when the babies are in utero, their intestine will poke out through that hole, and then the blood supply to the intestine will get choked off, and then that intestine will die, and they'll be left with insufficient amount of intestine. Adults, on the other hand, have different causes. They usually have had multiple operations, either for bowel obstructions from adhesions or from Crohn's disease, where they had multiple intestinal resections, or they've had trauma. Other causes for adults would be malignancy or complications from radiation or ischemic vascular disease. The most frequent symptoms of short bowel syndrome are frequent loose stools, which can also contain blood or mucus, which are signs of inadequate absorption. They also, with that, will get diaper rash in babies or perineal excoriation in older patients. Also, they will often have abdominal distension and bloating. They can also have pain with that as well. Short bowel syndrome patients are treated with a combination of medications and feeding strategies, with the goal being trying to augment the amount of absorption that their intestine can achieve. So the intestine will normally adapt after a large amount of it's resected, and we try to optimize that. And through these strategies, we're able to dial down the intravenous nutrition to the point that we can actually graduate the kids off the intravenous nutrition so that they're exclusively fed by mouth or by G-tube. Johns Hopkins is a prime place for patients to come if they have complex diseases, especially short bowel syndrome, because this place has the expertise in the people, the infrastructure, and the resources in order to take care of complex diseases. This past year, we opened a multidisciplinary intestinal rehabilitation program, which there are very few of in the country. This is a multidisciplinary clinic that involves pediatric surgery, pediatric gastroenterology with Dr. Darla Shores, nursing specialists, nutritionists, pharmacists, speech therapists, occupational therapists, and behavioral psychologists all working together to take care of patients through one clinic visit. The parents are like this because it streamlines their care, and it's also been shown nationally in studies to improve outcomes because you're able to provide a uniform care plan. We call our center the Circus Clinic. The inspiration for Circus came from the Big Apple Circus clowns, which are in the hospital, and they entertain the kids, and they give parents and kids a few minutes to forget about their disease. And so that was the inspiration for the name. The acronym actually has a lot of meaning. The Center for Intestinal Rehabilitation and Cure Using Science. The cure is, in fact, what happens to most patients. Most patients don't need a transplant. Most patients, after months to a couple of years, will be off of TPN and off their IV nutrition. And then science, we use a scientific method in the clinic to study our outcomes so we can keep track of what works and continue that. But at the same time, if our management, something we do is not helping, then we can get rid of that and move on.